Hey everyone, welcome to Geeks for Geeks. I'm Ishan Sharma and in today's video, I'll be talking about web scraping and how can you get started with it. Let's get started. This video is going to be more of a tutorial kind of a video in which I will walk you through the steps that are required, what all code you need to type, what does that code really mean, and we'll also see the end result from there on. Okay, so first of all, let's talk about the requirements, the dependencies that will be there for you to install first of all. So first thing is going to be Python. Okay, so we are using Python for doing this, and if you want to get started with web scraping, Python is a great language. Simply just go to python.org and you can install Python. I hope you can do that much. After that, now I'll show you how can you get yourselves the three or two modules that will be required. Number one would be Beautiful Soup, and the second one would be called as Requests. Okay, so now let's take a look at what all you need to do by going onto the laptop. Let's do this. All right, so as you can see, I have Visual Studio Code opened up and I have just made a file called as scraper.py, okay? That's the Python file that we'll be using. So first things first, we'll need to actually get Beautiful Soup, okay? So for that, I'll just go on to my Chrome and I'll just search for Beautiful Soup, and that is right there. This is the complete documentation. Highly suggested for all of you to go through this. You can also look at our Geeks for Geeks blogs on this thing, but let's go back and let's look at how can we do this. So just search for PIP, that is pip, that is Python package installer. So after that, we'll just click on this and we'll just need to copy this thing. Okay, so just copy here, and once you've done that, we can open up our terminal, and on the terminal, let me just go full screen here, just need to type pip3 install, and you can type the whole thing that they wanted you to do, right? So I am using Mac, so on that I have to do pip3, but if you are using Windows, you can just do pip and that should work fine for you. Just click on enter, and for me it says requirement already satisfied, so that means that I am good to go. Now let's take a look at how can we install the requests module. So first of all, I'll just say pip3 install requests. I'll press enter, and that is also satisfied for me. So now I have installed both of the modules that were required. Now let's go on and take a look at our file here. Okay, so what happens is that, let's try to understand what is web scraping essentially. Basically, we want to take some website and you want to scrape data from there. You want to take some information that you can use for your own purposes. Maybe you want to make like a price tracker for something that you want to buy online, or maybe you want to just see what the temperature is right now, or maybe you just want to see the latest blog on a particular website. So things like that, if you want to do, and that particular service or website does not have an API, then you can go ahead and use something like this. But just keep this one thing in mind, that not all websites are happy when you actually scrape their website. So just keep this one thing in mind. Make sure that your website that you want to scrape allows you to do the scraping. That's one thing to keep in mind always. So now what I'll do, I'll just go full screen with this. And first of all, we'll need to import all of them. So I'll just say import requests. And I would say from BS4, that is Beautiful Soup 4, import Beautiful Soup. So first of all, what I'll do is that I will get something called as a request, right? So request for a particular website, I'll just call it req, and I'll equate that to request.get, and I'll have these brackets, and in between I'll need to put in the URL of the website. Now it is not really required that you have a website. You can also just link it to a HTML document that you have in your own folder. But the thing is that if you are using web scraping, it is generally used for websites that are online and not on, you know, websites that are in your local folder itself. You can just go on, you can see whatever data is in it. But anyways, we will actually get some sort of a website. So I'll just go here and I will actually go to Geeks for Geeks, right? Geeksforgeeks.org. And here, what I will do is that, let me just close all of this thing over here, and I will click on inspect. Okay, I'll click on inspect, but we'll do this afterwards. I'll just copy this link of geeksforgeeks.org and I'll go back and I'll paste this right here. Okay, so after this is done, the next part that we'll do is that we will use something called as a soup. And in this thing, we'll just create an instance of beautiful soup. Okay, so beautiful soup, think of it like a class that you have and you're just creating an object called as soup. So here I'll just say that, okay, I want to get the content from this particular website. So I'll just click on content. And then I'll say that the parser that I want to use is just going to be called as HTML parser. Okay, so that's all that you need. Okay, so now first of all, let's just see what this soup actually has. So I'll just print out soup.prettify. Okay, so this prettify is important because else we'll just get some hodgepodge data. So I'll just save this, and next I'll just go into my terminal and I'll just say python 3 and scraper.py. again, if you are a Windows user, you will just have to say python and that should work for you. All right, so what did we see here? We just got a bunch of data. Okay, we got a lot of data. As you can see right here, this is indented because we have used .prettify, and if it would not, then we'll just get like a bunch of random gibberish. Now let's try to understand how can we get specific elements from this thing. So the first thing I will do is that I will just go here and I'll just say soup.getText. Okay, let's just try to do that first of all. So get underscore text, that's what I will do here. And let's just close all the brackets. And now let's just try to run this. So let's run. And as you can see, we get all of the text. So this is the text that you would be having in all of the elements that are inside of that. Okay, so this is how powerful web scraping is. Now, what else can I do? There's actually a lot of things that you can do over here. Let me just show you another example. So let's say you can make something like this, and I can just say soup.a. Okay, so here, or let's just go for soup.title. Let's say I just want to get the title of this HTML website. So I can just save this. So once we have done that, we can just say res.prettify. Okay, so let's do this. Let's save this right here. And now I'll just try to run this thing once again. And what do you see? You get the title. So this is what you can do. And of course, you can just say things like, let's just go for get text. Okay, so I can just do get text. And let me close the bracket, save this. And let's go on to the terminal. And let's just try to run this once again. So as you can see, we just get the text, not the title tag and all. Okay, so there's actually a lot that you can do, but this was just an introduction. You can also call a particular element based on the ID and the class they belong to. So you can add a lot of features on top of that. But this was just me scratching the surface on how you can learn web scraping. This is how you get started. You can also get the links of the images on a particular web page, and then you can sort of download them using this request module, and then you can try to use them in some other website and you can showcase that. There's actually a lot of things. I won't go into the details. This was just a tutorial for beginners to understand how web scraping works. You can check out our blogs on web scraping, on beautiful soup, on requests, on parsing. All of that would be in the description. And thank you for watching this video, and I hope to see you in the next one.